Okay, so this is my Hover Things Flip FPV frame. I quite like it, or I used to like it up until today. Put it up in the air today, and it seemed to be very unbalanced for some reason. I don't think I've done any changes to it since the last time I flew it. This time I put it up in the air, put through two batteries in each battery. It just seems so unstable. It wouldn't get a GPS hold, and it was always kind of leaning to one side. And if you threw it around a little bit, as soon as you came to a stop, it would just not stop. It would just keep running on forward. Or if you try to put a bit of a reverse on it, it would just chase backwards and keep coming backwards. So it was very difficult to keep in one spot. So something definitely up with it. It wasn't like that before, and I'm not sure. It was as if there was too much weight on one side, but I put two different batteries in and I made sure the batteries were centralized, especially on the second one, and it just seemed to be leaning over all the time, and that seemed to be causing some kind of trouble to it. Now, I did notice that where I was taking off was very uneven, so I think I need to maybe look at the settings of the NASA. I definitely need to adjust the gains on it because, again, I think those can all go up maybe 5-10%, not sure. Definitely wouldn't hold its altitude, which it's never done from the start, but I've never messed with the gains since day one. I've just used the same settings while I get it dialed in a little bit, get used to flying it. So I need to play around with the gains and just see whether the actual leveling of the NASA needs to be recalibrated. Did a GPS calibration on it while I was out there. Didn't help at all. It's something strange, something daft that's gone on. I'm pretty sure it's NASA based. But it does fly well. Now, the downside of it, another downside I should say, is the fact that I'm actually running it and have been running it on these 5000 milliamp 3-cell batteries. And they are just too heavy. I would maybe like to go down to maybe, I think, an optimum, maybe 3000, something around that range. I'm going to see if I can find a 4000, but I'm only using these because I've already got them, so it wouldn't be my choice for this. And I would use a 4-cell if I could. But these Gowie motors that I've got on it, these are only three rated as a 3-cell, so for now I'll stick to a 3-cell. But this is just too heavy. When you come to pull out, I had a few hairy moments there because when you come to pull out of any falls or you want to gain a bit of height to get over the trees, it just does not punch up at all. It seems to take an age and you're kind of willing it more than anything to get over the tree. So that's a downside with these. I need to somehow get the FPV kit on. Squeeze it on there, which will put the weight up. So, another reason to get rid of this. Flies okay once it's in the air with this, it flies okay. It's just the reaction time is too slow with these heavier batteries on. So, I'll try a lighter one if I can dig one out. It needs to be a 3-cell. I might risk a 4-cell. I think these Scorpions could well take a 4-cell battery. So, and I know the ESCs can, it's all geared up. I hesitate to ask, say that. Yeah, these ones are rated for a 4-cell. So that is my Ultimaker 3D printed GoPro sandwich camera mount. It's specific this time. This is specific to my Flip FPV. I noticed last time the one of the props on the wide setting for the GoPro, one of the props was in view, just ever so slightly. I tried to jiggle the camera over just a little bit this time. So really, I could do with it offsetting. I'll check them. I'm just going to check the footage again now and see whether the prop's still in view, because this mount may need modifying just a little bit, just to offset it to allow for where the lens is because it's not central. So I'll have a look at that sometime.